This is Sunita. I am going to explain you about what interrupt types, priorities and applications. After going through this lesson, you are able to differentiate what is hardware interrupt and what is software interrupt, and what are the priorities of the interrupts, and what are the applications, interrupt applications, you will understand. Coming to the interrupt types, so you can divide the interrupts into two categories, like hardware and software interrupts. And in the hardware interrupts, again two categories comes. They are called as maskable interrupts and non-maskable interrupts. And if you see the hardware interrupts, so the interrupts initiated by external hardware are called as hardware interrupts. That means if you see the 8086 chip, there are two pins called as INTR pin and NMI pin. If a signal comes on these two pins, those interrupts are called as hardware interrupts. And what are the sources of hardware interrupts? So you maybe hardware interrupt may come from keyboards and from the serial ports, or from the parallel ports, or mouse and other different peripheral devices. From the different peripheral devices, these hardware interrupts comes. And what is maskable behavior in hardware interrupts means, so the processor has the facility for accepting or rejecting the hardware interrupts. So programming the processor to reject an interrupt is referred to as masking or disabling, and programming the processor to accept an interrupt is referred to as unmasking or enabling. So what is this maskable behavior means? If you mask the interrupt source, then you can call it as a maskable behavior. And coming to the hardware interrupts, you have two interrupts, like INTR and NMI. Again, you can divide INTR interrupts from type 0 to 255. So some external signal may be allowed to interrupt the 8086 microprocessor. What are the instructions used to mask and unmask the INTR input is clear instruction, the CLI instruction and STI instruction are used to mask and unmask the INTR input. Okay, that means IF flag is cleared, IF flag is set. So based on the IF flag value, that interrupt is accepted or rejected. So that is how INTR interrupt acts. And coming to the INTR acknowledgement machine cycle, so whenever an interrupt comes from the external source has to give the type number to the 8086 microprocessor. So during if you see here, interrupt acknowledge machine cycle, in the second interrupt acknowledge machine cycle, the interrupting device will give the type vector to the 8086 microprocessor. Based on the type vector given by the interrupting device, microprocessor calculates the ISR address. So it will calculate the IP value by multiplying the type with 4 and CS value by adding 2 to the IP value. So CS and IP value now indicates the ISR address for that particular hardware interrupt. Okay, and coming to the next, how you can disable the interrupt flag means, as already told, with the help of CLI and STI. So why you are disabling the interrupt flag means, for two reasons you have to disable the interrupt flag. First one is, it prevents a signal on INTR input from interrupting the highest interrupt service procedure in progress. So if you don't want any other interrupt to interrupt the highest interrupt service procedure, you can disable the interrupt flag. And the second reason is, a signal on the INTR input does not cause the 8086 to interrupt it continuously. So if you won't disable this IF flag or INTR input, it is going to continuously interrupt and it won't execute the actual ISR related to that particular interrupt. So that's why you have to disable the interrupt flag. And coming to the non-maskable behavior, you have NMI input is treated as non-maskable interrupt, and here you don't have the choice to mask that interrupt. Processor has to respond to that interrupt by executing the ISR for that interrupt. So the interrupt is initiated to NMI pin, and all the software interrupts are also non-maskable in addition to the interrupt that is occurring, that is signaled by the NMI pin. So this is about non-maskable behavior. So the signal on the NMI pin and all software interrupts are non-maskable. And software interrupts, if you come to software interrupts, you have type 0 to 255. So these are nothing but program instructions. For example, if you see INT N instruction, so this is called as software interrupt, and you can have N from 0 to 255. This is called as software interrupt. And coming to the interrupt priorities, you have different interrupt priorities. So how can you assign the priorities means in 8086 microprocessor, so this has got the highest priority, divide by error, and INTN, INTO has got the highest priority, and single stepping has the lowest priority. So whenever divide by error occurs, for example, I will tell you two scenarios. So when divide by error and INTR interrupts occurs simultaneously, then 8086 first executes the divide by error. Why? Because it first checks the internal checks for the internal interrupts. So later, after the completion of this ISR, it will execute the INTR input. In the second scenario, for example, when divide by error occurs and NMI occurs simultaneously, so even though it is internal interrupt, but this is can't be disabled, so it has to first respond to the NMI interrupt. So after executing the NMI input, only divide by error ISR gets executed. This is the interrupt priorities. This is about interrupt priorities. And coming to the interrupt applications, so there are hardware interrupt applications and software interrupt applications. So simple input data can be taken through interrupt means. That means without making the CPU to continuously poll for the data input, it can take the data whenever interrupt occurs. So the interrupting device sends data by making use of these interrupt concepts. And next, counting applications to count occurrence of particular event, you can use this counting applications. And in the timing applications, you can generate a time delay, and you can use that time delay in timing applications. And coming to the software interrupt applications, to test various interrupt service routine procedures, you can use this, and to insert breakpoints in the program for debugging, and to call BIOS procedures in IBM PC type, and to execute interrupt service routine related to a hardware interrupt without the occurrence of that hardware interrupt. These are the uses of software interrupts. And in this lesson, we discussed about hardware and software interrupts and interrupt priorities and interrupt applications. Thank you.